even pandas aren't really black and white. They're actually colored. Okay, usually it's like disgusting, dirty brown because they're really sloppy eaters. Anyway, so instead of clustering in just the intensity space, we could cluster in RGB space. So this is notionally drawn here, right, where you can see that each point now belongs to a different color cluster, and here they are. And so you're grouping these pixels based upon their color. So now you're doing a quantization in three-dimensional space. Here's a nice example of using color instead of intensity, this original image here. And you can see, if you take a look at sort of the clustering based upon intensity over here, it doesn't do a particularly interesting job of segmenting the cabbage from the broccoli, which is something you should always do because you like one and not the other. All right. But over here, you can see that based upon the different colors, you get the different segments. And it's not rocket science, but it's just this idea that you have some things that have the similar intensity but are very different in their chroma, right? Their colors. And we talked about color space last time. All right. Notice, however, this pepper here and this pepper there, this system does not know at all that those two peppers are distinct, right? Because the only thing it uses to create these clusters is the distance in color space. You might ask, can I do something smarter?
Can I do something smarter?
Thank you very much. Yes, you can include not only clustering in, say, intensity, but you can also cluster. So here we have this little part of the black ear and this dark part of the eye, and you might want them to be in separate clusters. Well, how would you do that? Very simple. Instead of just clustering on intensity, you would add the position as well. So now we have a three-dimensional space of intensity, X and Y, or as shown here, intensity, X and Y. Here we have the black pixels. Together, they're low in intensity, but separated in different areas in X and Y. And so you would get a different, two different clusters. And of course, if you've got intensity and you can do position, you can have color and you can do position. And the point here is that your feature vector is getting longer, looking for features that you'd all like, or as many as possible, to be similar in order to say that everything is in the same cluster. So notice that if I include the X and Y here, so for example, these two pixels, this green up on the top left and the green on the bottom left, they can't be clustered in the same segment because they're different along some dimension, namely the Y dimension. All right. So that's the utility of adding these dimensions.